Hey guys, Stealth here. Welcome back to XCOM 2. Previously, in case you missed it, we rescued our first scientist, which leads me to get a little bit of science boost. And I gotta say, it is definitely appreciated, because we are still on our way to research resistance communications so that we can start to reach out to other areas and make contact there as quickly as possible. My armory is doing okay. I have most of my people alive and in pretty good condition. But here's the problem. When running larger squads, these soldiers get fatigued. And the more you put fatigued soldiers on squads, and especially if they get hurt when they are fatigued and they take a hit, that's when they're going to be in the hospital for a long time. Now, if you take a fatigued soldier, such as Shane here, he's fatigued for 2 days. If you take him on a mission and he gets hurt, it's going to be out of action for a week. If you take a soldier who's been fatigued for 9 days on a mission, he or she could be out for a very substantial period of time. And so far, it hasn't happened yet that much that I need to get my guys into the hospital. It's only a matter of time, is what I'm afraid of. So I need to expand my roster. I need to get more and more and more people in. And yes, initially they're going to be rookies. I need to train them up to squaddies and higher as soon as possible. As for my facilities, I still do not have a guerrilla training school yet. It's still unusual. I do have enough cash for it, but I'm probably going to spend that on getting more rookies in, just expanding the roster and potentially going for the upgrade or going for the Advanced Warfare Center so that if my soldiers get hurt, I can get them back up faster. But let's see what the mission what the game has in store for me right now. Oh, actually, this is very, very fortunate. I can get rookies for now. I can get those for free. And I have the locator beacon here from the previous episode. Now, when you mentioned in the comments that this is actually safe to get, it is not a mission, and it shouldn't be any difficulty getting that. And with it, you do get some nice weaponry, which I haven't seen yet. So let's have a look. It's going to be a pretty long process to scan all this.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
Right, what's going to be next? I don't know if I'm going to have enough money to deploy resistance radio beacons. But I am curious to find out what the bonus is that Asia can get.
I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
Commander. We can now work to establish contact with local resistance groups operating out of regions around the globe. Once we've collected sufficient intel to make contact, we'll need to scan the target region for the operative signal.
Right, I have 3 contacts available. I already used one. It's my base zone. That's New India. I could continue the scan, but I'm going to try grabbing at least one more zone, and hopefully 2, before the supply drop comes in to maximize my income.
Course for West Asia.
I hope it's 3 days. 5 days, damn it.
Attempting to establish local regional.
It's 3 to 5 days, and sometimes you just get lucky, and sometimes you get completely shafted by the game like this. Maybe another resistance comm center, which is again quite controversial, would be a better option here. Oh, this is tough. The normal logic of what you go for, so for example, Guerrilla Tactics School, Advanced Warfare Center, and Resistance Comms, doesn't work because of the whole fatigue system and because of my larger squads. I do have a decent amount of people ready. What to do? What to do? I have more money coming in soon, 5 days from now. I'm expecting one mission to come up between then and now. So let's get. Let's see,
Commander,
do I have rookies available?
You recruiting new staff
one.
For the engineering team, but
right.
As it stands, we have people still waiting.
Okay,
for
we're gonna recruit 2 rookies.
We can have them working.
It's
on
gonna be Geoff Nelson
and
Miguel Garza,
ability.
And I select these guys mostly on accuracy. And as Lily just pointed out, I can dictate my engineer to make herself useful. I have 74, which is not going to be enough to get anything done. 41 supplies, alien alloys. Alright, let's go for this one. Oh, actually, putting a workshop up in the middle might be better. It's gonna just take a while. 20 days. Bloody hell.
Tigan seems to have a habit of scratching that scar on the...
Okay. Let's see if anyone wants to play.
Curious. Added.
Commander, we've established contact with the local resistance and we're ready to move on the alien black
site on your
order.
This is a 55 zone.
Advent's been keeping this facility
a close
guarded secret.
I probably won't be able to get it in time, but it's at least
sure
a little bit more income than new
for
Indonesia
before we send
or
them
new,
out there.
Correction,
I've
or East Asia.
Our latest operational
so we're
going to
capture this one.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts
yes,
until
Miss
we upgrade
Shen, I know,
our systems.
Don't worry.
Nothing on the local comms. Advent's been quiet lately. I'm guessing we have you to thank for that.
Our pleasure, Den Mother. Enjoy it while it lasts.
We plan to. Our water purification...
Massive signal coming from the Advent Network Tower. It's global. Sir, I think you want to see this.
Fellow citizens, for 20 years, the Advent Coalition has worked tirelessly to repair the ravages and injustices of the old world. Under our stewardship, our cities prosper, our people flourish, and our world heals.
And yet,
among us, there are still those who would refuse to acknowledge the truth, who are determined to see all that we have achieved.
Multiple radar contacts on approach to Haven Alpha 7.
That must end.
Even as I speak to you today,
you've got incoming on approach.
Your signal's breaking up.
Outlying territories to end this scourge once and for all.
They're right on top of you.
Losing you, Avenger.
Raise them again.
We will ensure your continued safety and well-being throughout this crisis.
Get your people out of there!
With your cooperation, we will overcome these radical elements and usher in another 20 years of peace and prosperity.
They don't stand a chance. Commander, we should get a squad ready to deploy.
Right, we have some work ahead of us. Retaliation site. Forgot that this is actually going to come up. Let's see what kind of mission this is. Because sometimes you get a resistance defend haven, or a defend mission. Also known as a siege mission. Nope, it's a retaliation. Okay, that makes my life a bit easier. Just a bit, though. I'm going to take the three squaddies. Correction, rookies. And everyone who is not completely fatigued. That's Astrid, that's Sharon, that's the Shinobi here. The Gunner. And I don't like the Samurai, so we're gonna take him as well. I still don't have any upgrades for weapons, I still don't really have any useful material. So, I don't have that many options. What I do have somewhere is a flashbang grenade. If someone would like to give that thing up so others may use it, that would be wonderful. Thank you very much. Right, so this is what we have to go with. Some of these guys are acquainted with each other, so I have a very tiny bonus, but the score is still too low for it to actually yield any sort of effects in my squad. So we're just going to have to wait and level these boys up a little bit more. Have them work together.
Sky Ranger deployed.
In position for deployment.
Night Jewel.
Word just came down. The aliens have amassed a huge force to... And those people desperately need any help we can provide them. We're going in to eliminate the enemy threat and secure the area.
Alright, it's the same old. On the one hand, I have superior numbers if I come up against one squad. If I trip multiple squads, that rule does no longer count.
Sky
Menace 1-5, hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians. Advent came in hot and so did we. You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
In case you're curious, Sharon Cook, for some reason, really enjoys her sports bra in order to go to conflict. So she's now known as Sharon Bikini Cook. So if you just see someone so-called Bikini, that's why. I'm trying to personalize these guys a bit. I'm trying to get a bit attached to them, because I usually just don't. I usually just don't find them too interesting. They're just soldiers to me.
Rolling.
But as they are with you longer, that should become less and less of an issue. You should become more and more attached to them and their abilities. Now, my Shinobi, which you're looking at right now, is concealed, so can do a bit more aggressive scouting, and so far it seems that there's no pods. I am, however, concerned that one of these two folks might in fact be a faceless, which would be a very nasty situation. Now that I think of it, I forgot to bring someone who has the ability to... actually, I forgot the trainer weapon, which is the weapon which has the stock attached to it.
Bon, bah, si c'est comme ça. Scan en cours.
Oh, that's not cover, but whatever.
No hace falta repetirlo.
How come no one ever does things to make my job safer?
I'm on it!
I always love hearing the voice of Sam Fisher. So they're up in the structure. That's bad news. That means that they have a significant height advantage if I close in. Which I'm gonna have to do. Alright, where's my samurai? Emile Laurent. This should be in the zone of both of them.
Y'a quoi par là? Vous pouvez y aller!
That's two civilians. Got them. Excellent. Next one's over there. We're gonna have to scout a bit. Preferably as safely as possible.
Affirmative. Moving out.
She can still not see anyone.
Got eyes on a hostile squad.
And now she can. I might even break concealment next turn in order to lob a grenade and have all of those guys drop down. It is definitely something that will take at least a couple of them out of play and make my civilians that much safer.
I'm on it.
Espero que valga la pena.
You got it.
Also, I'll put some of these boys on Overwatch.
Yeah.
Overwatch.
Oh, my hammerhead. You shouldn't be that far back. Oh well. Damn, I think they overheard me there. Oh, there's the Overwatch. Good hit! That's half a sectoid down. We'll get the other half in next turn. Now they only have one move to get themselves into cover, which they use to run right into the next Overwatch.
Keep your head down.
And apparently there's another squad there. Another sectoid soldier. Massacres another civilian. Go on. Let's have a look. So we got an advent sectoid. The sectoids, as far as I know, are nothing special. They don't have any specialty stats. The advent sentry are really good if they are put on Overwatch. They can use reaction fire if you just fire at them, not even if you move. The Advent Trooper is a standard guy, and there's another Advent Trooper who does not have, to my knowledge, any special abilities. It looks like you are almost stuck here, but not quite yet.
Good copy. Moving on target.
Alright, this is good. It means that there's no second patrol close yet. I can use that to keep my folks safe. High cover if and where possible. Oh, this is the samurai. Okay, we can use the samurai to lob a grenade at that guy.
Okay, j'y vais.
Because I rather doubt that he's going to be able to accurately hit anything. other than using grenades. There we go.
Grenade!
Let's aim down. Next, we can put you into high cover, which is always a favorable position.
Roger.
72%. Take him out. That's two low damage rolls. I mean, they can go 4-6 with that gun. But it works. He's down. So, that's two left. That's a sentry and a trooper. Problem is that I'm now too far away to reliably lob grenades or to hit them. So, I'm going to have to dash in and get a bit closer.
Got it!
And still have high cover. And not bunch up my troops, because these boys tend to throw grenades every once in a while. Which makes my life a lot more complex. See, this is potentially a good position. If not for the fact that they're too close together and that a grenade could ruin the party. But I think that he is too far away to actually be able to throw a grenade.
J'y vais.
As for Miguel Garza, there's no high cover there. This tree is too tiny to actually be effective. And you're a rookie, so your combat effectiveness in general is questionable. And this might be too far forward. I might detect another pod. Not good. Alright, you're gonna move here.
Está despejado.
And I'm not going to put you in Overwatch. Oh, that's a 54%? Take it. He actually got him.
Mejor así.
Well done, Mr. Garza. Not bad for a rookie. As for you, I'm going to keep you on Overwatch. In case someone or something decides to change from civilian to a faceless, I want to have someone who can fire at him. Let's see, sentry. What are you gonna do? It's a bit of an overkill, not civilian. He's moving. And firing. And hitting! Oh, he wasn't low cover. Ready for anything. This means that this sentry can shoot at anyone who attacks. So he doesn't even necessarily have to see someone move. But anyone who attacks is going to get returned fire, or is going to take a return shot from him. Unless he gets killed outright.
Tango down.
That's when that doesn't happen. Alright, Laurent, check out the civilian. If it is a civilian, get him out.
Allez, bougez-vous.
Yep, it's a civilian. Alright.
Je passe en vigilance.
Time to push up, because we still have quite a few civilians left. And not enough time to do it in.
Je dois pouvoir faire ça.
These two civilians could still be bad guys. So,
moving.
For me it's a bit of the more likely, or the deeper you go, the more likely you are to run into a faceless. Because the less civilians there are, and the bigger the chance that you're actually going to run into a bad guy. Hold there.
Got it covered.
Astrid, you're gonna hold there. Garza, you're gonna hold. That's my gunner, he can move
What's
up.
The catch?
Hammerhead, move up.
On the move!
All right.
On Overwatch.
The sectoid soldier so far, I think, has killed three civilians. He has to go. All right, Joff, you're pretty far out of position. Let's have a look at some of these so-called civilians.
Moving to position.
Yeah, I didn't know that, but this is what I was worried about.
rumors about some kind of shapeshifters. I'm guessing this is it.
It is a remarkable species.
Where is my samurai?
Means of containment.
He's out of range.
Don't even think about it.
So we're going to have to push forward and make sure that people can take shots. Fortunately, those guys usually don't have a lot of cover, but they do have 10 hit points, which means you need to hit them quite a lot. And that is not helping. I need actual damage output, not these flea bites. Garza, I know you're hurt, but I need you to hit him. 66%. That's good. That's a high roll. 2 hit points left. Now, I know that I have someone parked right next to him, but I want to try and get her on Overwatch in case that Sectoid soldier makes a push. 80%. Gunner. Beautiful. Target down.
That's gonna leave a mark.
Oh, yeah. I believe it will.
Pas de soucis, chef. Viens par là.
Overwatch.
Covering now.
Christina. Keep scouting.
Target location.
I want to know how big that pod is. What exactly they have. Alright, 4 guys.
Overwatch. Overwatch.
Get closer.
Y'a quoi par là?
You're just gonna have to make a big dash forward right into the open, but that's. It's gonna happen for now.
Affirmative, je couvre la zone.
Oh no. I was hoping he'd miss at that range, and he did. Okay, so now we have this pod sitting pretty much behind that tree. I need to find a position where I can have a bit of a better look at them.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Shit.
I'm spotted.
I thought that she would be able to get close without being detected, but apparently not quite. Oh, that's a mistake. Look at that guy. Thinks it's a good idea to park himself right next to a fuel drum. Maybe we need to educate him that that is not the best possible position for him to be in. Let's see, who could actually hit him? Could you? I don't need to hit the soldier, I just need to hit the tank. No, not yet. Oh, no. Yeah, actually, you can hit the recon drone. No thanks. That's fire, that's bad.
Fast.
Bikini, can you hit that fuel drum if you park yourself behind this tree? Yes, you can. This could hurt. A lot. I just took off 6 hit points. As for the others that we got, we have an Advent Trooper, that's a standard. An Advent Wrecker, I believe, can throw grenades. But I haven't really studied the list of opposing targets that well yet, so I'm not exactly sure.
Ubicación confirmada.
Alright, I'm gonna have to play an Overwatch. Oh, do I push forward? No, I'm gonna have to reload.
Sounds
this
good.
Guy is pretty good at outputting damage. You are pretty exposed, so I could either try to run you back or just hunker you down. I think the second option is safest. Hammerhead. Run forward. A bit. And then
Overwatch!
I'm probably gonna try and close in on my forward soldier, on that shinobi, which means that the Overwatches might get him. There's one. Wow! That's the samurai who gets the minus 20 aim penalty. That was a good job. Let me guess. Nope. Not Overwatch. Ah, damn it. I was hoping to save that civilian. Okay, how many do I have left? 5 civilians, and I still need to save 2. So we have work to do. There's still plenty of civilians here. 1, 2, 3, 4 potentially. But where do I go? Yeah, it was indeed the samurai who hit the shot. Look at that, now he has a 0% chance. So that shot that he hit was actually incredibly lucky. Let's go for the 48. Actually, the grenade's safer. It's pretty much a guaranteed hit. That's him down. There's no high cover.
Okay, je vous fais confiance.
This is currently out of line of sight of the soldier, but he might be able to get a good reaction fire in. My gunner, if I push him here, I might be able to fire at the soldier. Not yet.
I got a message. Fine.
You have a shot, but that's only 31%. Hold your fire. Switch to Overwatch. You're going to do the same thing from over here, but with a shotgun, I really doubt if it's going to be any use. Need to be a bit careful with you. I'm surprised that he hasn't panicked. I need to get that wrecker out of the way, but if I push forward, I have no high cover whatsoever. So I'm just gonna have to hold.
I'm on it.
And Hammerhead currently is pretty much rear guard. All right, soldier, what's up? What are you gonna do? Oh, really? That's your one and only choice to go for a civilian? And Overwatch. Damn it. I don't really want to run the Overwatch if I don't have to.
Hold on.
Jeff, you were standing next to a door, son. But okay. That's not it.
Can't believe this.
Yeah, that makes 2 of us. I could do a flash attack on him. Look at that, 9 to 11 damage. Very high amount of damage, but I'm not convinced. Short range. Shotgun. It might work. Or I could do a running gun. But that opens up this area, which has a pretty high probability of having a pod. Which I don't like. Can you take a shot at that guy and hopefully hit him? 32 only, but whatever. Yeah.
It's still moving!
No surprise there, really.
Scanning.
He has a shot, 24% only. He's gotten lucky before, but not again. Oh, that did expose him, it blew away his cover. That'll do. Oh, really?
Damn it.
Yeah, that kind of sums it up. That was a 79% chance. There, let the shotgunner deal with it. Which is my samurai. So hopefully he's gonna get another promotion. Hammerhead, move to this position where I was expecting the next wave. Bad choice. Bad choice. Because now we can move up. He really shouldn't have done that. Can my shinobi can get him. But it's... Well, it's the edge of the map. If she can attack from here, she's in cover. Okay. All yours. Gotcha. She could kill people with a mohawk of her by the looks of it.
Target neutralized.
Menace 1-5, status confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear.
It's too quiet.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Alright, as a bonus reward, because I did the mission flawlessly, which I don't think is true considering I got one soldier wounded, I get a bonus reward, which means that I get an additional recruit. That's excellent. I thought I only get bonuses at flawless. Hope there's any new promotions, especially for the rookies, but maybe for my squaddies as well.
Highest standards. Excellent work, Commander.
One of my rookies is gravely wounded for only 9 days. Could have been worse. Ah, specialist. Good. A very accurate specialist at that as well. Next, we have a recon operator. Recon operator have some nice perks so that they can push forward quickly. And they can also be used as semi-snipers, depending on how you build them. They have a tree that's called Recon Sniper, and this tree is much more geared towards scouting and attacking them at range. Or you have Force Recon, where you basically just fire at as many targets as possible. And you are a tank. That's another new class. The tank has a very small capability of hacking. I mean, he can do it. He's not good at it, but he can do it. The tank can also use the protection protocol. This activates an energy shield and gets him, I believe, 2 to 3 armor or 2 to 3 defense. So he gets a bit of a small shield, and you can tie that into Here I Am. This is a free action. It makes the soldier the main target. So if you have someone else who's out of cover, you can have this guy come in and tank the damage. That's all that he does. So you move him, you activate the Here I Am, then the protection protocol, but here's the problem. It is probably guaranteed to hit. That's a bit vague. It's more often than not going to hit. And hopefully, if it's not too many soldiers, it's going to bounce off of the armor. Okay, my trooper is ready. Trooper tree hasn't changed that much after the last couple of trees. She can mark a target for the rest of the squad to actually be more accurate at. Or Lucky Shot. Lucky Shot is fantastic. It's a guaranteed pistol shot that hits. And it does 2-3 damage with a standard pistol. And that's only going to ramp up as we get better and better pistols. So she can take a lucky shot and, for example, a shot with her shotgun or her assault rifle in this case. I'm going to go for a lucky shot. My Shinobi has gotten another promotion. She is the Saboteur. This makes her covert, so that enemies cannot detect her as likely, or as not as likely to detect her. Low profile, of course, is the familiar one. Partial cover is now full cover, and Blade Master turns her into a bit of a semi-samurai. But I'm going to use her as a super scout. And I believe... Yep, we have two more. We have our first sergeant here. This is the samurai. Bladestorm, which is normally a perk that you see all the way down there, but considering he's not that good with his main weapon, this is something that you can very quickly get early on in the tree. Free sword attacks on any enemies that enter or attack from melee range. This makes him extremely capable of just chopping down soldiers as they are coming out of a reinforcement pod. So if there's a dropship coming in, you park this guy on the flare and he's likely to take out one, two, potentially even three targets. Danger Sense is an interesting one. It tracks movement within 20 meters, and he cannot be surprised. The thing is that, normally, I don't find a good use for this. I haven't really actually gotten anything out of that. And Low Profile is one that makes partial cover count as full cover. This is one that allows your samurai to, for example, aggressively push forward, get the chop in, so get the sword attack in, and then use the small cover that is available to still stay more or less concealed. But I'm gonna go for Bladestorm. And our gunner has gotten another promotion. Gains plus 10 aim for successive shots at the same enemy unit. This is especially valuable if you're firing at targets which have more hit points. A trooper of 2 to 3 hit points is not that likely to be a severe problem. A sector pod with 20 hit points, much, much more so. However, my guy already has 82 points of aim, so I don't think he's that likely to profit a lot from it. Will to survive. Enemy damage is reduced by 1 when in cover and attacked through that cover. So, he has to be in cover. If the attack then still happens to go through, the enemy damage is reduced by 1. It's sort of interesting. And Demolition unleashes a volley of bullets that destroys your target's cover, damaging or destroying it. Deals no damage to your target, but of course it allows the others to actually open up. It allows your squad to engage the target. These are all pretty good perks. But I think that with his high aim, Locked On isn't that good. Will to Survive is okay, but Demolition is exclusive, or pretty exclusive, to his class. So we're gonna pick this one, so he can blow up cover for other soldiers to clear the way. A couple of corpses, no loot, unfortunately. We have a faceless autopsy available, and we get even more supplies. Commander. I'd say that's a pretty good result.
Now that we've finally got this place up and running, we should be able to access some of these dormant alien systems. Let's see if you two can play nice. What the?
Shen, getting some kind of interference up here. Seems to be hitting us across the board.
Working on it.
Something triggered your remote uplink. But how is that possible? No one knows these systems.
Shen, power readings just spiked. What the hell is going on down there?
Commander, I'm too old to start believing in ghosts, which means someone had to access that unit remotely. If they can access Rover, there's no telling what else they might be able to do. I strongly suggest we make investigating that signal our top priority.
Now this opens up the next set of missions, which is Shen's last gift. It's one
Looks
mission.
Like Shen was able to confirm the signal's
one.
Origin.
It's one mission that gets you, how should I describe this? It gets you mechs of various types, depending on the type that you prefer to build. They're pretty good, they're pretty powerful, but they take the slot of one of your soldiers, and while they can do a lot of damage, they're not very easy to hide. And they're likely to always take some damage in a mission, unless they somehow miraculously stay in cover and not get hit. I'm considering doing that mission, but I still have plenty ahead of me. I'm still making contact here. I have a supply drop coming in. I still need to do the locator beacon. I need to get some rookies. And I didn't mean to click there. Not yet. We first need to get the contact.
Setting course for Sector 1, the
Although,
Arctic.
Technically, it doesn't matter at this stage, because I won't be able to get the contact before the supply drop comes in.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Right, radio relays are available. Let's go for...
The Advent offices appear to be similar, if not physically the same as the common Advent trooper in terms of power and agility. However, field reports indicate a more developed mental acuity, as the officers do provide tactical directives to the subordinate Advent forces.
Work in progress.
I must admit, having successful...
Commander, we can now construct radio relays in any region where we've
made
contact.
220 first month, not bad.
Priority message coming through, Commander. Putting it on screen now.
I had high hopes for the Resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
Now, there's two potential dark events coming up, neither of which are very appealing. This one allows them to get more soldiers to drop in on me for a month, so that's 2 to 3 missions. The other one makes it so that Advent becomes aware of your sneaky behavior, giving you 50% less time to complete concealed missions. That's a lot less. That is a severe problem. Because, for example, if you're trying to save a beacon, or you're trying to rescue a VIP, you have to make your way to the Avenger, this could be a severe problem. And then again, if you're doing a guerrilla op and you get reinforcements, it's not good either. So I'm going to try and target this one, Advent High Alert, with the next guerrilla op. For now, let's get some supplies.
Avenger plotting new course.
And yes, I know I still have the Resistance waiting there, but this is far more important. There we go. We're going to ignore that. And we're going to finally build a structure. It's going to be the Advanced Warfare Center.
I'm
going to set up my engineer to help out there. Should take it about, what, 10 days? 11. That works. Alright, continue making contact.
Setting course for the Arctic territories.
And I could have a look at what the bonus is going to be for Asia. Let's see. Quid pro quo. Black market items cost 33% less intel. I don't even have the black market yet. So it's not useful yet, but it's nice to grab it early on.
This was easier than your last procedure, Doctor.
Central, Commander. Yes, I find the process to be far less disconcerting when the subject has already expired. The results, however, it's best you see for yourself. My autopsy of the Advent Captain has confirmed the existence of an implant, similar in design to the unit I extracted from the Commander. But there are differences.
What kind of differences?
The data you see is being pulled directly from this Advent Captain's implant. The sequence here is essentially you, Commander. Or at least the tactical information they were processing through your mind.
As you can see, the data is nearly identical. They were using you against us.
Yes, however, the Advent data shows signs of decay. Removing the Commander from their network has likely caused significant damage.
Network?
Yes. What we're seeing here is a psionic network. These implants are capable of receiving and transmitting information, a great deal of information, somehow encoded in a stream of psionic energy. My working theory? Advent uses this network to augment the tactical readiness of its troops, as well as disseminate orders from its central command. Observe. Subject's diminished condition, the implant continues to have an effect. A truly astonishing achievement.
Or a weakness.
Potentially. But I need direct access to their network to know for sure.
I'm guessing that won't be easy.
We'd need an active link. And that would mean hacking a live Advent officer.
Like I said, not easy. Still, it's the best lead we've got. Your call, Commander.
New objective added.
Yeah, that's something else that we need to postpone for a while, the proving ground. I'm not likely to get that
We're
thing done anytime soon.
We're ready to move when you are, Commander. I've updated our objectives based on the latest information.
The Advent Captain seems to provide a means of stabilizing the link between the local subordinates and the Advent Net.
Knowing.
Yes, we're gonna skip that one. It allows me to get the battle scanner.
What, if any, advantage
and
the Advent hybrid
there is something that I'm a bit curious about. I'm not getting any loot.
Their visual acuity will no
I didn't
doubt
accidentally blow up any soldiers that had loot because I do have a mod that enables me to see who has loot and who doesn't. I didn't blow them up. So someone, or somehow, the mods are not actually generating the loot that they should be, nor are they making the missions as difficult as I had expected them to be. So I'm gonna have to look at that and see what exactly is going on. But for now, this is the end of the episode. I hope you enjoyed the operation, short as it was, and pretty easy actually. And that, actually, the next episode's gonna be a bit more challenging. That is the mission. So, thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed, thank you for joining, and I'll see you soon for more XCOM.